Good morning, everyone. This is Nitin Jaikumar, working as Assistant Professor at School of Diploma Studies, Department of Mechanical Engineering at RK University. Today, as first topic for the course, we'll be going through as introduction on machine design. Many people talk about design, designing things, then it is forwarded to production and manufacturing. But the prior thing which we have to decide or think that what a design is and how it looks like. Many a people does say that designing is something where people are investing their time and their knowledge to create something new. But there are lot many contrary statements in terms for design, because there are few things we have to take care while designing something. So when we move forward, we will go for the basic definition which is given in most of the journals or most of the books or magazines, that machine design or design of machine elements can be defined as the use of principles of science or engineering, imagination of a machine element or part or subpart, and engineering knowledge for a system to perform concerned functions with maximum efficiency with greater economy. As the definition says, that we can say that we have to design a element, a part or a subpart, keeping some imagination in our mind that this part or this subpart will work in actual conditions, will be something like this, and because of this designing, and this part will perform such kind of activity which can improve the efficiency of particular machine. Like we say that if we talk about a lathe machine and we have to improve the efficiency of lathe machine in terms for some numbers or the output criteria. So what we do, that we want to change the dimensional parameters or geometrical parameters of chuck or the tool post, or we will be changing the type of motor we will be using for the lathe machines, or else we will be changing the type of tools what we are using on the lathe machine. But we have to use some principles of science and engineering in such a way that we are improving the maximum efficiency, but we have to take care in such a way that all the things are at one place. That means costing also is there. Standardization, that means whatever standard the company or the policy we have to follow, and what are the modifications can be made. So that is the important thing we have to take care. So if I ask you a question, like, what could be the basic process for designing a ceiling fan? Everyone knows ceiling fan is used at the offices or at the places where the ventilation or the requirement is there. But what are the basic processes? Means if I want to design a ceiling fan, what could be the basic process for that? So think about it about a minute or two, and write down the points which would be helpful for that thing. I hope till now you might have thought that what could be the basic points and what are the things to be thought before designing a ceiling fan. See, we are talking about designing, we are not directly going for the manufacturing stage. So these points are there, but these points can differ from person to person and the place to place. So first point is selection of mechanical elements like blades, flywheel, rotor, blade arms, bearings, etc. That means the mechanical elements which will be helpful for a ceiling fan to be in working operation condition, that we have to take care that these are the basic elements which we need to design. And selection of shape of ceiling fan blades. Now all these, the ceiling fans which are available in the market, as you see in the advertisements also, depending upon the usage, that means that is the last point, that is our application, that means where we are using these fans, we will be designing the shape of fan blades also. So how it should look like, how it could be ergonomically or aesthetically different from other fans, and the selection of material for mechanical elements. When we are selecting the material for mechanical elements, we have to take care that all the theoretical calculations or practical calculations regarding the life of particular mechanical elements must be there. So we have to take care of that thing also. So these are the basic process. These steps could be varied from one person to other person, and there could be more steps, but these are the basic steps that how to design a ceiling fan and what could be the processes or what could be the stages we could be deciding. Now when we move ahead, that classification of machine design, there are several types of classification, but these are the basic or the required stages of machine design, such as adaptive design, then comes development design, then comes new design, industrial design, optimum design, and computer aided design. So what is adaptive design? Adaptive design means a designer who is really concerned with the adaptation of already existing work or existing design. That means he does not need any kind of new knowledge or new skill to improve, but there is already the design is available in the market or in the center or the place of work, and he has to just follow the designs and just go on. That means there will not be any major modification or major things to be changed. There will be very minute modification, something like dimensional change or like any kind of geometrical changes in the drawings or design. So that is adaptive design. Next one is developmental design. Developmental design means specific training and research development department is set up in such a way that you will be adopting the same design, but you will be changing some things. For example, you will be modifying the design in terms for adopting new material or new method of manufacturing or production. That means you will be bringing some new idea, but the design will be in such a way that you will be giving some major modifications. So that will be the development design. That means it is at the development stage. Next is new design. New design means you will be doing lot of research, ability, creativity, innovation to develop something new and something unique which is apart from any existing product. That means you will be developing something new which is new, very very much new in the market, and but the thing we have to take care that these designs may be fail or may not, may be success in the market. It's depending upon the overall survey of the market policies and the customer feedbacks or whatever feedbacks you take. Next is industrial design. Now industrial design is totally depending upon the production aspect to manufacturing any machine component in industry. There are several industries, those who are making several kind of heavy equipments for another third party industries, and the all these designs that comes in industrial design. Next is optimum design. This is the design which gives some basic objective function under some desired constraints. That means there could be a minimum constraint, a maximum constraint, that under these constraints the particular machine or particular design must fulfill these criteria. Next one is computer aided design. Computer aided design, that means you will be using some computer systems in terms for simulation softwares or the designing softwares or the CAD tools to do the creation, modification, analysis, and optimization also. This is something very new in the machine design, where people are pretty much excited to do the computer aided design for simulation purposes, and for modification and analysis purposes. These are the basic considerations while we start or while we think about the machine design. That means what are the factors to be considered in machine design, such as types of load and stress, motions of part, that means how the part will move, or the what will the kinematics or the rotational parameters. Selection of materials plays a major role, because the company or the design policy which the standardization takes place, that they have to take care. Form and size of the parts, frictional resistance and lubrication, convenient and economical features, that means the features which you are actually using, that should be economical. And economical in terms of the customer feedback, that means customer should be able to be the part or the machine they are using, they should be compatible. Use of standard parts, standardization, the whatever standardization the company follows. Safety of operation, that means whatever machine you are using, that should be in safe conditions, and the safety procedures has to be taken care of. Workshop facilities means the workshop which is readily available for manufacturing these elements or these machines, they should be available. All the workers, laborers, operators, parts, raw materials, everything. Number of machines to be manufactured, these things comes under the workshop facilities. Cost of construction, that means how much costing is taking place in construction, production, manufacturing, in terms for salary or wages, in terms for raw materials, in terms for new methodologies you are opting, and the assembling. Obviously, assembling and dispatching also is a major thing in the machine design. Next is the process in machine design, that what could be the process in the machine design, how to follow in the machine design processes. First one is need or problem definition, that why we are doing this design and for what purpose we are doing the design. So this actually problem definition comes from the market survey and the customer feedback, that they used to give the feedback that they are not satisfied with this product or they need some improvement. Next comes the synthesis. In this, you have to select some possible mechanism or the group of mechanism because of which some desired motion or desired working operation takes place. You have to come with optimization, because in the next, that is analysis of force, you have to calculate all the forces acting on each member or each element and what are the possible stresses or possible things is being developed under the suitable limit. Next comes the material selection, that means after doing analysis and synthesis, you will conclude with a material selection, that with this material selection or with this size and shape, I will be going for this material selection under the standardization of particular company is following. Then design of elements in terms for shape and size, that means you will be calculating all the designs and all the shapes and size and stresses, all the calculations you will be going through, because of which you will be concluding that these are the suitable limits or the basic limits of which should not deflect or deform after this permissible limit. Next comes the modification. What are the modifications you basically need after the calculations you consulted? Because these modifications can be done in terms for the past experiences and the present judgment also. Next comes the drawings and detail drawings. In drawings, you will be having several type of drawings, such as detailed and assembly drawing. This could be a computer-aided design, and in few companies or few places also, they go for the hard in terms for sheet design also. Later stages, it comes for production, assembly and dispatch. After all the approvals from all the sections and all the process and all the drawings have been approved by the major authorities, now you will go for the production, assembly and dispatch section, where you are actually going for these stages. So this is the basic process of machine design, where you will be carrying out all the stages and things we have to take care. This could be differ from standard to standard and person to person. So this was the basic introduction for how the machine design is and how the machine design is carried out and what are the things to be taken care of, because this plays a major role in development stages and improvement stages. So thank you very much.